Hello students, I welcome you all to another lecture of Pharmaceutical Jurisprudence. In our last lecture, we finished with the Schedule M and today we'll be starting with Schedule N, right? So Schedule N basically has certain requirements, minimum requirements that a person needs to fulfill if he or she wants to, you know, run a pharmacy. So let's start. So as I told you in my previous slide, Schedule N basically has list of minimum equipments that are required for the effective running of a pharmacy store. So talking about the entrance, so the first point is the entrance. So the front of a pharmacy from which a person will enter into your pharmacy, that particular area, that particular section should, you know, bear an inscription stating pharmacy, so that the person who is entering your store knows that this is a pharmacy store, right? Then talking about the premises should be, you know, dry, they should be well lit and they should be well ventilated with sufficient working space, and the floor of the pharmacy should be smooth and it should be washable without any cracks, because if there are cracks, then there is a possibility of accumulation of dust. Then a separate dispensing area should be there in your pharmacy, and that particular, you know, dispensing area, it should be separated by a barrier so that no person from the public can enter into that particular dispensing area, right? And the area of the section to be used for the dispensing department, it should not be less than 6 square meters for one pharmacist working therein, with additional 2 square meter for any additional pharmacist who is working in the same area. And the height of the premises should not be less than 2.5 meters. Then in the dispensing area, a sink should be provided with adequate supply of water, and the entire pharmacy, the premises of the entire pharmacy should be provided with a proper quality of water supply. And the premises of your pharmacy, they should be separate from any private room which is used for any personal reason. And the washroom should be well ventilated, and the washroom should not open directly into the pharmacy. Now coming to the personnels who are working in the pharmacy store, first point is that the pharmacy, it should be operated under the supervision of a full-time registered pharmacist, right? And all the activities of dispensing of the drug product should be done under his supervision. Now for the staff, for the staff members who are working in your pharmacy, for them a proper training plan has to be, you know, designed and maintained, and the staff needs to be given a training from regular time interval, and the documents, the records of all the trainings which are being given to your staff member should be maintained. Now coming to the furniture and apparatus, the furniture and the apparatus which is present in your pharmacy, it should be well adapted for its use, and a pharmacy should be provided with a proper dispensing bench which should be made up of a proper material, preferably of stainless steel. Now the drugs, the chemicals and the medicaments which are there in your pharmacy, they should be kept in a room which is appropriate to their properties. For example, you know, if a particular medicament has to be stored in a particular temperature condition, so the pharmacist should ensure that that particular medicament is, you know, stored only in that particular temperature condition. This is basically done to avoid the deterioration of the content. Then every container which is there in the pharmacy, it should bear a proper label of appropriate size that is visible, and a pharmacy should be provided with a dispensing bench. This I have already told you in our previous slide. Then a pharmacy should, you know, be provided with proper cupboard and storage shelves with proper lock and key for storing the chemicals which are poisonous in nature. On that particular cupboard, the tag of poison should be mentioned in red color. Now talking about a pharmacy should, you know, be provided with the following minimum apparatus and equipments. For example, there has to be a suitable number of tablet and capsule counters and spatulas. There has to be a refrigerator unit which is capable of storing products within a selected range of temperature, and a suitable range of labels that shall bear the details of the pharmacy, the batch number and the expiry date should also be present. Now, the pharmacy should be well equipped with an effective and appropriate security system, and a suitable fire protection system should also be there to avoid any calamities. Then a container of all the concentrated solution should bear a label stating that this particular solution is to be diluted before use. Then all the records and all the registers which are there in the pharmacy, they should be maintained in accordance with the law, right? For example, all the records should be maintained as per Schedule U. Then any container taken from the poisonous cupboard, that is a cupboard which is having proper lock and key system, it should be replaced therein immediately after use, and the cupboard should be immediately locked, and the keys of the cupboard having the poisonous substances, they shall be kept in the personal custody of the responsible person. Mostly the responsible person is the full-time pharmacist, registered pharmacist who is there in the pharmacy, right? All the medicaments should have labels, appropriate labels. Then there are certain general requirements. For example, the original copies of the license of the premises and the approval, it should be displayed to the public so that the public can, you know, have a look at it at any point of time. The original registration certificate of the pharmacist who is working in your pharmacy, a full-time pharmacist basically, that should also be displayed. The name of the pharmacist in charge, it should be printed, it should be kept on a table which can be, you know, easily read by any person who's coming into your pharmacy. Then good personal hygiene instructions and procedures, they should be, you know, written and displayed in the pharmacy, and all the persons who are working in a pharmacy should follow those procedures. Then activities such as smoking, drinking, chewing, it should be strictly prohibited in your pharmacy, and a tag should be there in the pharmacy stating that this is a no eating or no smoking zone. Then all the control drugs like I told you, poisonous drugs or habit forming drugs, they should be kept under lock and key, and all the registers and records of ordering and dispensing of the control drugs, they should be maintained and they should be available at the time of inspection. Then a prescription record should also be maintained. If a manual prescription record is not maintained, then the other option of maintaining a prescription record is an electronic record, and the password of that particular electronic record, it should be shared only with responsible persons, right? Then there has to be a written procedure for handling all the expired drugs, and that particular procedure should also be displayed so that people handling expired drugs know what they have to do. And all the expired drugs, it should be, you know, segregated from all the other drugs from the entire stock, and they should be kept in a place which is labeled as expired medicine, so that nobody picks up any medicine from your expired medicine and gives them to the public. So these were the basic requirements that you need to fulfill if you want to, you know, run a pharmacy store, and these requirements are there in Schedule N. Right? So this was all in today's lecture. If you have any queries, any doubt, please feel free to reach out to me. I am always happy to solve your problem. Thank you so much once again, dear students. Thank you.